Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Amen, Pastor Joanne. Oh, the Lord has now decided to release his tremendous glory towards the meeting in Nakuru. Right now, as I speak, the Lord has commanded his glory towards the meeting that is going to take place in the next 24 hours in Nakuru. And the Lord has now decreed that the glory will move as his servant, the mighty prophet of Jehovah, will leave from Nairobi towards Nakuru, through Naivasha and all these other towns, that the glory of the Lord will move ahead of the man of God and bring a lot of healing even on the way in that direction. And the Lord has also decided that when he comes back at the end of the meeting, the glory will move on this side. Even the people at the roadsides will be healed. This is a very tremendous moment in the history of the church. The Lord has now decreed that as he releases from Nairobi, towards this direction, from Nairobi, he releases his servant towards the meeting in Nakuru, the glory will move in that direction, almost up to 20 kilometers ahead, 40, and bring a lot of healing on people. And the Lord has also decreed that people will now be healed as they are coming to the meeting of the Lord. And as they enter the streets of Nakuru, there will be a big healing that will touch many people. Many cripples might not even enter, might not reach the meeting before they walk. They might simply enter the streets of Nakuru and their feet strengthen and begin to walk. Many tumors. This is going to be the most historic visitation since the church was created. And again, we are living in a very tremendous time. We're living in a fearful time when now the Lord has decided to bring his unspeakable glory, glory not seen, not heard by men. And at this hour, as he releases his prophet towards Nakuru, the Lord has said that as the mighty prophet begins the journey, the glory will go ahead of him and heal a lot of people on the road. You'll meet cripples that have walked already on the road, Naivasha and many places, and people from Maralal, living all the way from Kehancha, living from Kakamega, Kisumu, people living from Machakos, living from Busia, from Nambale, many other places in this country, Lodwar, people living from Kapenguria, all these places, as they move, the deaf ears will open on the way, the blind will see, and that's why it was very important to record them in the original condition in the churches before they begin the journey. So you have the records of the people and their infirmities and their diseases before they are healed. This is going to be a historic visitation on this land. Why? Because this land has hosted the mighty prophet of the Lord in a very mighty, mighty way for a long time. Because the seat of the Lord is in this land. Again, because this land has hosted the mighty prophet of the Lord with great honor. So the Lord is going to release his glory. He has to open the floodgates of heaven. Now, anything and everything will be possible now in the mega glorious, the super glorious, mega and mega revival meeting of Nakuru. Everything and anything will be possible. So it will be so big. This is historic. This will shake the earth. It will stun people. It will stun them in the most shocking manner. It's amazing that this comes at a time when my words have just been fulfilled in Italy, actually, including the blue windows I talked about, the buildings that will tumble down and so forth when I was in Reggio Emilia and when I was in Italy. It's amazing that at the same time, when he is speaking this tremendous blessing of healing, restoration, many, many cripples will walk, many, many blind will see, many, many deaf will hear, many, many mute will speak, many, many lame legs will be stretched and columns increased and created and touched down, many eyes, ears will be created, many paralytics will have spinal cord injuries, broken back, broken skulls, tumors dissolved, cancers dry. At the time when he's talking about HIV deleted, changing the blood of people, at this time when he's speaking this massive love of grace here, then at the same time, the same tongue, my words are being forbidden in Italy, people are dying from the earthquake. So that tells you really, really that our God is not democratic. He only respects those who embrace repentance and righteousness and champion Jesus. So I bless you, Kenya. I bless you, Kenya, again. I bless the this land. I bless it a fourth time. I bless it a fifth time. I bless you a sixth time. I bless Kenya seven times. I bless you. You will visit this land in an unspeakable historic. The Messiah. Shalom.